Here's a sample of that wavy lace that I showed hand tolen, but now I worked it up on this machine. This is a push button machine that came out before the punch cards did. So what you do is you're going to push whatever buttons to select the needles. Now here's the chart I had for the hand tolen. And here is the chart I'm going to work with on this machine. Because I need to transfer stitches on the third row, I decided to start out with waste yarn. Should have done a row of ravel cord, but I cast it right on. The waste yarn is really thin stuff that I could cut and probably pull through. But anyways, I knitted two rows. So now I'm going to start transferring the stitches with the lace carriage. I press in button 1 and 7. I take the handle over here so it selects the needles for me. I need to push back the end needles because I do not want the end two stitches to be transferred. Those are to be knit only. Of course, some of the newer machines, you have these things you can put on the bed where it will not touch those end needles. So now I'm going to take my lace carriage, and from left to right, it's going to transfer those stitches from those needles one over to the right. Now, I've tried taking the lace carriage to transfer those stitches back because that's what it has to do. Sometimes it'll do it, sometimes it won't. So I finally just decided to hand tool this first row with the two stitches on the needle. So I take those, I could see the empty needle there, and I just transfer the two stitches back to the left. I'm going to line the needles up again, the needle butts. I do not need the lace carriage to do anything, but I need to get it back to the left. Then I'm going to take the K carriage and knit two rows. So I have my six eyelets. Now I'm going to clear this row by pressing the blue button. So now my next row in the chart, I press in needle 1, and it's always needle 1 for the transfers, and then needle 6. I take the, got to move the handle. Again, I have one needle over here on the first two I do not need, and when I count 2, 4, 6, there's my 6. I take my lace carriage, I go across. Again, I hand transfer those two stitches from the right to the left. I line up the needle butts again, and then I look at the next row. Well, I need to clear my stitches here, and now I'm going to press in button 8. And when I select them, I could see it is the stitch here to the right of the empty needle that's going to transfer. Again, this one over here I do not want to transfer. So I push that needle back, I push the lace carriage across, and I look, I see 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, that's it for this row. I knit two rows with the lace K carriage. Then I go on to the third row of the chart. Again, I need to release those stitches, and I need to push in needle 1 and needle 5. I select the needles, I do not want this end one because it's part of the two stitches. 2, 4, 6. Push the lace carriage across. Hand transfer the double stitches from the right to the left. Line up those needle butts again. And 1 and 5, so 1 and 5. I need to release those stitches. Now I go to needle 7. I select those. Here's the end one. I push it back. Move the lace carriage across. I come back because I'm not selecting the needles. I release that button. I push in needle 8 or button 8. Select those, select those needles, push that one back, move the carriage across, and that's the end of row 3, chart row 3. I knit 2 rows with the K carriage. Then I go on to row 4. So I release that. Row 4, I do needle 1 and 4. Select the needles, do not want that one, transfer the stitches over, hand tool. So at the beginning of each row of the chart, there's 5 rows to the chart, the first transfer you need to hand tool them back is all, but after that, the rest of it is the lace carriage doing all the work. Line up the needle butts. So I was at 1 and 4. I released that. The next one is 6. Select the needles. Only does the 3. Knit across. I guess I don't have them lined up just right. And then I have 1 row to go back. Release that. Do needle 7. Select those needles. Push that one back. Move the carriage across twice. Release that one. And do needle 8. Push that one back. Transfer over. When you're doing needle 8, you're going to just push the carriage over to the left, take your K carriage, knit 2 rows. And now for the final row of this. So I have now 1 and 3. So I got 2, 4, 6. This is part of the 2. I do not want that. And what I can do is take my 3-prong transfer tool, because the set of 2 stitches, and I could have done this on the first row as well, I could just take those, even though one's empty, and move them 1 over to the left. Of course, that's only the middle ones. But then I need to, oh, no, that is 3. Third set over here. The first set would have been 1 and 1, but then you have the 2 sets in the middle there. So now after 1 and 3, I clear that. Now I push in button 5. Select the needles. Push that lace carriage to the left and to the right. Clear that. Push in 6. Select the needles. Push that lace carriage left and right. Clear that. Push in needle 7. select the needles. Oh, gotta put that one back. Left and right, clear that. Needle 8, select the needles. Again, that one over there goes back. And I push the carriage, lace carriage to the left. Take 2 rows with the K carriage. And that's it. I just keep repeating that part of the chart, which is actually 10 rows, not including the first 2 rows, until I'm done with this. So let me knit up a few more repeats of this to show you, because I don't want to show you just that little piece there. But anyways, once you get the hang of it, it does go pretty fast.